Welcome you all to the course on Introduction to NGO Management. I am Dr. Manjari Agarwal from School of Management Studies and Commerce, Uttarakhand Open University. And in this session, we will be discussing about the elements of strategy. Now coming to strategic planning. To be an effective NGO manager, you have to be very systematic and a strategic planner. Because strategic planning bridges gap between where you are, where you want to be. It is an intellectually demanding process. It's a blueprint that outlines the organization's mission, vision, and purpose, and all aspects of its operations, and hence guides and supports the organization's governance. So strategic planning involves an articulated plan that determines the direction of the organization. It helps you to document your vision, mission, core values, long-term goals, and subsequent action plans for your NGO. It ensures that the efforts of all the members are aligned together for some predetermined goals. And hence, strategic planning helps an organization in allocating resources effectively and responds appropriately to the dynamic, volatile, or you can say ever-changing environment. It tries to identify the desired future of the organization and assist to create a vision that will help in taking present decisions concerning the allocation of resources. It helps an NGO to scan the relative environment as per its strategic intent to explore the organization's potential opportunities and threats. Now, this word, strategic intent, now what it refers to? It refers to the purposes for which an organization works. It determines the framework within which an organization performs its functions and follows a predetermined course of direction and strives to achieve objectives within this framework. It gives you an answer to the question, what exactly are we trying to accomplish? So it carries a sense. It is an express statement of what an organization aims to do in the long term, which means it provides a sense of direction to the entity. So, hierarchy of strategic intent comprises of vision, mission, goals, objectives, and plans. The organization's vision refers to the broad category of long-term aspiration that the organization intends to pursue. It involves the characteristics of futurism. From vision, the mission statement is carved out. The mission is a statement that explains what the organization is providing to the society. A mission statement describes what the organization is, where a vision statement describes what an organization wants to become in the future. The mission is the purpose or the reason for the organization's existence. Vision and mission leads to goals and objectives. The mission is very specific. It's more specific as compared to vision. Whereas goals make the mission more concrete and hence provide guidance and a unified direction to the organization. Now, what are the objectives? So objectives are measurable, time-based activities that help an organization to achieve goals. They are the targets or the outcomes of an organization that are generally specified quantitatively, whereas goals are qualitative in nature. Further, plans depict the specific actions an organization take to accomplish the objectives. Now coming to vision, vision denotes farsightedness. It refers to what you dream for your organization. So this will show you the path to propel your dream to reality. Vision is a broad forward-looking statement for the benefit of the society. But in case of NGO, we can say it is for the benefit of the society. And in case of businesses, it could be for the benefit of the present or the prospective customers. So in the exact sense, let us discuss what vision is. Carter in 1990 defines vision as the description of something, an organization or the corporate culture, a business, a technology, an activity in the future. L. Namaki considered it as a mental perception of the kind of environment an individual or an organization aspires to create within a broad time horizon, and the underlying conditions for the actualization of this perception. Miller and Des describe vision as category of intentions that are broad, all-inclusive, and forward-thinking. So therefore, a vision expresses the desired state that an organization would like to attain in the distant future. Mission. Now coming to the next one, mission. Mission of an organization is an important element in establishing the strategy of the organization. The mission defines the purpose of why this organization exists, and incorporating some ways in which your vision is being fulfilled. Mission defines the basic existence of an organization. Therefore, it tries to address the fundamental or key questions. These are what an organization is and why it exists. Hence, putting in other words, what venture are we in and why are we in this venture? A sophisticated response to these questions shall help you in formulating an apt mission statement for your NGO. As it is organization reason for being, it will also help an entity in crafting, executing, and evaluating strategies in a professional way. It includes the scope of its products and services in case of firm or a company. However, in the case of NGO, it will be the scope of its services. Generally, it will be in the scope of its services. So mission is the purpose or the reason for the existence of the organization. It is an expression of the ambition, an envisioned visioned future, and a realistic dream of what an NGO wants to become. The mission is a statement that explains the role of an organization that it plays in the society. Thompson defined mission as the essential purpose of the organization, concerning particularly why it is in existence, the nature of the business or businesses it is in, and the customer it seeks to serve and satisfy. So mission statements need to be communicated throughout the organization and even among all the employees or volunteers, so that all their efforts are pulled in the right direction, or you can say for the social cause that NGO is working for. It provides the basic philosophy of what the NGO is all about. A rational, effective, and a sound mission statement should possess few characteristics. Like, a mission should be feasible and achievable. This means that a mission could be ambitious or challenging, but it should be realistic and achievable. A mission statement should neither be too narrow nor too broad. It should be crystal clear and should lead to action. It should be simple and easy to understand at all the level of the organization. The mission should be motivating for the employees, so that the members of NGOs are inspired for action. It should stimulate enthusiasm and commitment. A mission statement should direct and encourage the ongoing pursuit of organizational strategies. It should be unique and distinctive. It should contain its philosophy, values, beliefs, and hence mission statement should include its responsibility towards various stakeholders and even for the society at large. So it should indicate major components of a strategy to be adopted. It could also denote core values and faith of an organization. It is the communication both inside and outside an entity which narrates the basic nature and philosophy of the organization. Let's see a few examples of mission and vision. Now, mission and vision of CRY, Child Rights in You. Their vision is a happy, healthy, and creative child whose rights are protected and honored in a society that is built on respect for dignity, justice, and equity for all. So they are dreaming that there should be a happy, healthy, and creative child whose rights are protected. Their mission is to enable people to take responsibility for the situation of the deprived Indian child and so motivate them to seek resolution through individual and collective action, thereby enabling children to realize their full potential. To make people discover their potential for action and change, to enable people's collective and movements encompassing diverse segments to pledge their particular strength, working in the partnership to secure, protect and honor the rights of India's children. So this is so broad, clear, crystal clear what they intend to do. Taking another example, ARPAN. So this NGO is operational at Mumbai, Thane and Palghar in Maharashtra and across India through their various training programs. So their vision is the dream to have a world free of child sexual abuse. And their mission is to empower individuals, families, communities and societies and society with the prevention and intervention skills to reduce the occurrence of child sexual abuse and heal its psychological, social, sexual and physical consequences. Taking another example of Vagdhara, let us refer to the vision and mission of this NGO that is working in Rajasthan, Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh for bringing change in quality of life of tribal and poor families. Their vision is that the poor and tribal region of India have climate change resilient, sustainable livelihood, ensuring education, health, right and participation for their children. Their mission is creating and nurturing vibrant institution of tribal communities at transjunction of Rajasthan, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, states of India, integrating new generations and indigenous technologies and practice, ensuring sustainable livelihood and realization of childhood. So they are mentioning that they are trying to blend latest and native technology for what? For sustainable livelihood of the tribal community. So they have made this thing very important. So whatever activities would be around the framework of this mission. Another mission, example of mission and vision is of International NGO Safety Organization. Now, their vision is a world in which people affected by humanitarian crisis are able to access aid and assistance they need with confidence, dignity and safety. And their mission is to support the humanitarian community with information, analysis, advice that enhances situational awareness, supports informed decision making, strengthens operational practice and enables humanitarian access. So they're saying all the work would be towards like data and mapping, and this would be for the decision making, for strengthening their operational practice. And they are working for this humanitarian perspective, the humanitarian community, utilizing this information. So mission and vision serves as a guidelines for a strategic decision, framing objectives and goals, and also they provide a basis for more detailed planning. Mission and vision provides an NGO with a unique purpose, intent or reason, which distinguish them and in fact their NGO from other NGOs of its kind. Now coming to goals and objectives, an organization needs to translate its vision and mission into objectives and goals. In a strategic plan, your goals and objectives are very important aspects. These goals are based on vision and mission. Goals are basically broad statements of what the organization aims at in long term. So you can say goals can be lofty ideas, or you can say that they are quite generalized statement having a long-term perspective, and hence these are broken down, or you can say goals are subdivided into short-term objectives. However, there should be consistency or complete integration of individual goals and institutional goals, and we say it as goal congruence. Sub-goals of an organization must be congruent to achieve one set of objectives. Now coming to objective, what are objectives? They are the end results of plan activity. They are the ends which the organization intends to achieve through the basic nature and operations. Hence, these should be very clear, specific, concrete, quantifiable, and measurable. These should be related to time frame. That means an objective should set out the time frame in which it should be achieved. Hence, objective must be a smart one. That means they should be specific, measurable, achievable, relevant or realistic, and time-bound. So for NGOs, objectives should be as far as possible be measurable for assessment of results and assessment of strategic gap and audit. Azhar Kazmi defined goals and objectives as goals denote what an organization hopes to accomplish in future period of time. They represent a future state or an outcome of the effort put in now, whereas objectives are the ends that state specifically how the goals should be achieved. They are the concrete and specific in contrast to the goals, which are generalized. Objectives make the goals operational. So, from this discussion, you can infer that goals are general guidelines which illustrate what your organization wants to accomplish in the future. And objective includes strategies or steps that are implemented to attain the goals you identified. Goals are qualitative, whereas objectives are quantitative. So you can easily measure and compare the objectives. Let's say there is an NGO. For example, there is an NGO that intends to bring changes in the lives of transgender people in their local community or the welfare of trans persons by providing support assistance in education, medical treatment, legal standing, cultural and social upliftment. Goals for this NGO is safeguard the fundamental human rights of transgender and ensure their empowerment by assisting in education, skill set, training and digital literacy. Objectives of this NGOs can be like to build a partnership with at least 20 companies for creating jobs for transgenders within 6 months, to organize 5 career guidance seminars and counseling sessions within 3 months for strengthening digital skills among transgender, to organize skill enhancement and capacity building programs in the field of beauty therapy, let's say makeup artistry, fashion designing, coding, and customer care executive. So, goals are open-ended statements, whereas objectives are clear-cut statements that specify what is to be achieved and have a defined completion date. They are more specific and outline the who, what, when, where, and how of reaching the goals. Goals and objectives should be challenging, but as far as possible, they should be realistic and achievable. Now, another aspect is, here we are about to discuss this towards, is regarding core values. The core values are the ones that drive the organization. The core value of an entity will communicate the generally shared faith of the entity, established set of behavior and procedure, and of course, notions about how the work shall be carried out by an organization. In fact, the vision of an entity is firmly knotted around an organization's core values. It tries to channelize the resources of the organization and efforts of the team to some of those values and therefore providing direction to the activities. So the value system of an owners or board of directors determines the value system of even NGOs. Their core value and the associated behavioral norms build the organizational culture that fosters creativity, innovation with utmost honesty, sincerity and teamwork. Organizational culture consists of these core values and norms of behaviors that contribute to a unique working environment of an entity. While business groups often mention that these values in their official publication and declaration, but in some of the cases they are not taken seriously on the grounds. However, it is very essential for NGO to integrate such values in their strategic plan. Let us now refer to core values statement of few NGOs. Here, USA, they work around the globe to save lives, defeat poverty, and achieve social justice. And their values are transformation, then integrity, diversity, excellence, and equality. In case of transformation, they believe in urgent action, innovation, and the necessity of transformation within the world and their own organization. They say that they are accountable to the people and partners. They humbly serve transparently, sharing their results, stories, and lessons. This is that they know that by embracing differences actively, includes a variety of voices, and joining together, they can solve the world's most complex problems. So the excellence in, they challenge themselves to the highest level of learning and performance, tapping to the best of human spirit to create impact. In case of equality, they say that they believe in the equal value of every human being and the importance of respecting and honoring each individual. They know that change happens through people. So what are their core values? Their core values are transformation, integrity, diversity. They are working for excellence. They are saying that their core values are excellence. And they believe to have an equal value of every human being. So equality. So these all will serve as a foundation for all the works, all the work or the activities they undertake. The Care India works towards motivating and encouraging its staff to imbibe, internalize, and demonstrate these defined core values of the organization. They say their core values are respect, integrity, commitment, excellence. They believe and appreciating dignity. They try to maintain social and ethical and organizational norms and try to adhere to the code of conduct. They try to fulfill organization goals with full commitment. And again, they are setting high performance and standard or benchmarks for themselves. Coming to next, the Association of People with Disability, APD India. This is based in Karnataka. Their core values are, as mentioned in their website, are integrity. As you can see, they says they act honestly, ethically, and responsibly in all aspects. Empathy is another core value. They are sensitive towards people, thoughts, emotions, and experiences. Next is accountability. They try to demonstrate the responsibility, transparency, and commitment to the highest standards of openness, of professionalism, integrity, with all the stakeholders. This is that the collaboration is another core area or core values. They commit to the participatory processes, knowledge sharing, teamwork, excellence. They demonstrate excellence in processes, products, and service delivery. Diversity, they nurture an internal ecosystem, and they're catering to the diverse genders, cultures, ability, views, and needs. So core value statements expresses or they depict noticeable norms of behavior. Organizations are trying to translate abstract core values in their norms of conduct. So you learn that core values are expressively or depict certain norms of behavior. So in this session, coming to the summary part, you learn that organization is a structured or coordinated group of people with some shared goals and objectives, and they work jointly for achieving these goals and objectives. You also learn that a for-profit organization is established mainly to generate a profit, that is to earn more receipt or revenues than payments. Whereas non-profit organizations, they are not driven by objective of making a profit. They are involved in welfare and socio-economic development of people by undertaking a wide variety of services. Strategic management for NGOs is important for resolving operational issues, reducing inefficiencies, minimizing conflicts, and thereby facilitating organizational development. Organizational strategy, organizational design, and organizational culture are important segments of organization dynamic model. You also learn that strategy tries to match the resources, capabilities, and core competence areas of an organization with the goals, product, and markets for achieving an institutional advantage. You also learn that strategic planning bridges gap between where you are and where you want to be. Vision and mission leads to goals and objective, and the mission is more specific as compared to vision. Whereas goals make the mission more concrete and hence provide guidance, or you can say some unified direction. The core values of an entity will communicate the generally shared faith of that entity, established set of norms or behavior procedures, and of course notions about how the work shall be carried out by an organization. I hope you found it valuable, and I really appreciate your listening. Thank you.